Space, the final frontier. While it was just a TV show, that little speech at the beginning of the original Star Trek show really did do a good job of capturing our feelings about space. It is those feelings that drive our love of astronomy and our desire to learn more and more about it. The thing that is most exciting about studying the universe is also the most frustrating, and that is that no matter how expert we get, we are always just getting started. But if it's any consolation, some of the most advanced minds in science and from history always felt that way about space. Even the greats such as Copernicus and Einstein looked up into space and felt like they were just a speck in the presence of such infinity. Of course, space is not infinite. There are some mind-blowing concepts about how space works that we have ahead of us to conquer. The Big Bang and the expanding universe alone was enough to set your mind to spinning. But then we have the coming of Einstein and the theory of relativity to set the entire idea on its ear. All of a sudden, space is not just three dimensions, but the dimension of time becomes exportable, and retwisting and maybe even travel through time seems almost possible. The frontier of space is as much a journey of the mind as it is of distance. Now we have the string theory that could revolutionize everything we know about space, time, and how the universe relates to itself. We can just say, no, we have discovered enough. It's the final frontier. The Starship Enterprise would not stop exploring, so neither can we. Because there is a hurdle still ahead that has a name but no real answer to it yet. That may also be the value of science fiction. Not only are science fiction writers often the visionaries of what comes to be in the future, but they give us the idea that space is noble, that despite how big it is and how small we are, we can conquer this frontier like we have conquered others before us. For mankind, that is often enough. If we can get the vision that we can conquer something, even if it is something so massive, so impossibly huge, it seems that we are capable of anything. And the love of astronomy, maybe unlike any other force on Earth, has brought together mankind toward that common goal of conquering the universe. But more than that, it is as though this is what we are created to do, to reach out to the stars, may be our destiny. If so, then our love of astronomy is more than a hobby, it's a calling.